Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will be discussing about the next type of data structures. They are stack, queue and binary tree. Now up till now what we have studied is linear array and linked list. In the linear array we store the data in consecutive memory location, whereas in a linked list we divide our node gets divided into two part, information part and then the address of the next node. Now my both the data structure, they were of linear data structure because my data was getting stored into a linear way or in the linear fashion. Now my next data structure is called as tree. In the tree is a non-linear data structure. Here my data gets stored into some hierarchical fashion, or you can say their data gets stored into a hierarchical way. Now in our syllabus we have the binary tree for the study. Now see this is called as a binary tree. A binary tree is defined as a set of finite set of elements, and the every element is called as node. Your binary tree can be a empty tree, or I can call it as a null tree, or it gets classified into a distinguished node T1 and T2, and my top of the node or top of the tree is called as what? Root. Now if you see this binary tree here, my A is called as root of the binary tree, whereas my B and C, they are called as left subtree and right subtree. So your binary tree can be classified into a root of the tree, and remaining nodes, they form the order pair of disjoint binary tree T1 and T2. So here my root of the tree is A, whereas B is called as T1 and C is called as T2. I call them as what? Left subtree and right subtree. If your T1 and T2, if they are non-empty, then I can call them as left successor and right successor. Now in this particular diagram, my both T1 and T2 are non-empty, so I call them as left successor or right successor. Now in this binary tree, there are total 11 elements into it. So I can say the total number of nodes in the above binary tree are 11. Here, child of the same parents are called as sibling. So DE, GH, they are the siblings, because D and E are the child of same parent B, whereas G and H are the child of same parent called as C. The node with the no successor are called as terminal node. Here D, F, G, L, K, they are with no successor, so I can call them as terminal node or I can call them as leaf. Now the line drawn from your parent to child is called as edge, and the sequence of these edges is called as path. For an example, A is a parent, C is a child, so line between A and C I will call as edge. The sequence of all edges is nothing but your path. Now next what we have to study is depth of the binary tree. The path which contains maximum number of nodes into it is your depth of the binary tree. For example, if you will see this, in this path there are 4 nodes A, C, H, K. Then I have one more path A, C, H, J, L. Here I was having 4 nodes, in this path I am having 5 nodes. If you will calculate the other path also, you will get to know that this path is the longest path which is having 5 nodes into it. So the depth of this binary tree is called as, the depth of this binary tree is going to be a 5. Now next we have to study how to draw a binary tree with the given expression. Now suppose if my expression is A minus B divided by C into D plus E, then how to draw a binary tree for the above given expression? We have to identify the relationship between every element. For an example, now A and B both are joined with the minus sign. C and D both are joined with the multiplication sign, and C and D both are joined with E with the plus sign. So I will be drawing a binary tree something like this for the above expression: A minus B, C into D. C into D both are joined by plus sign, so C into D plus E, and this is my left subtree, this is my right subtree, my left and right subtree both are joined with the division sign. So in the above binary tree, my division is root of the tree, or I can call it as top node of the tree, whereas minus and plus, they are my left subtree and right subtree respectively. Since they are non-empty, I can call them as left successor and right successor of the tree. In this binary tree, the depth is going to be a 4, because the longest path contains maximum 4 nodes into it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the longest path has maximum 4 nodes into it. So the depth of this binary tree is nothing but what? 5. Here A, B, C, D, E, they can be called as leaf, or they can be called as terminal node, since they don't have any successor. And A, B, C, D, multiplication and E, they are called as child, they are called as sibling, because they are child of same parent. So I hope you have understood the concept of binary tree. Now next we will move to the stack and queue. Stack and queue again are the data structure, but in this data structure, the data gets stored into some different way. First, we will concentrate on the stack. The stack data structure is always closed with the one end, and it is open only at the top. So I can say the insertion and deletion of an element in the stack takes place only at the one end, called as top of the stack. In top of the stack, the item, the push is the term used to insert element into a stack, whereas pop is the term used to delete element from the stack. So suppose if this is the stack, then this is how I will be inserting element into a stack, and this is how I will be deleting the element into a stack. So it means the element which is inserted last, that is going to be a remove first. So I called it as what? Last in, first out. Last in, first out means the item which is inserted last, that will get removed first. Why it's so? Because it is closed at the other end. So obviously the element which I inserted last, that will get out first. Now the next data structure is called as queue. Queue is also called as FIFO. FIFO means first in, first out. So the item which is inserted first, that will get removed first. The example of the queue, you can take it as what? The queue waiting for a bus at bus stop. The person which has approached or which has come into the queue at the first, obviously he will be getting or he will be boarding the bus first. So I will call it as what? FIFO. In the queue, insertion and deletion takes place from the both the ends, means insertion takes place from the one end, whereas deletion takes place from the other end. So these are stack and queue. These are the again other types of data structure. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.